Welcome to the video presentation of the Introduction to Multisim. Here we have our Multisim page open and we're going to build some simple circuits. So the first thing we need to do is we're probably always going to use a ground. So we need a couple grounds, at least one ground. Okay, and today let's go ahead and just use a battery. There are other ways to get power, and I'll show you those in a second. So let's go to basic and grab a 1K resistor, and let's put three of them up there. Okay, and let's make this a 2, so we change this to 2K, and let's make this guy 4K. All right, so let's get out a DMM. Very first one says multimeter. And let's go ahead and measure our resistance. Just like in a real circuit, we should never use a multimeter under resistance with power. So let's open him up. And we need to turn the circuit on, and let's look at resistance, and we have 1K. So let's turn it off, and let's go ahead and measure the other one. So let's just move the wire. We see this, we have our X and our flag. Let's go ahead and move that. X and flag move, and we can move this meter and straighten out the wire. So let's go ahead and see what this guy is. So let's turn on again, and we have 2K ohms, which it is. So that would be the multimeter reading for resistance. Okay, so let's build a series circuit here. So let's just disconnect the wire so we can click and delete. Let's turn it off first. It will not do anything with the power on. So let's, we could connect these by moving them. We get a red dot, move red dot, they're connected. And then we could just connect the wires, click, click, and we can move this, red dot, it's connected. And of course, we always need to finish our circuit. And if you want to change colors of the wire, just click on the wire, right click, segment color blue, and now we have a blue wire. So this is effective when we're using a oscilloscope because it'll change the color of the traces. So let's go ahead and change this to a 3K so I don't have to do any heavy-duty math, so it'll balance out. So we, when we get our 12 volts, we'll do a little Ohm's law here. So let's double check our series resistance. Turn it on and we should have 6K, and we should get 2 milliamps, 12 volts divided by 6K. Turn it off. I'm gonna do the wires. Okay, so let's measure the voltage across our first resistor. And let's add another DMM, and let's use this one as a current. So we've got to break the wire again. And if the current's negative, we could always just change the direction of the wires. So let's go, we're going to go current, DC, and this guy is going to be voltage DC. And let's see what we got here. We got 2 volts there and 2 milliamps. And that looks like a good Ohm's law circuit. Okay, so let's go ahead and put in some probes. So let's stick a voltage probe here, and let's take a place a current probe here, and let's see what we're going to get. And we have 12 volts because that's coming out of our battery, and we have 2 milliamps, so that's the way that we use probes. Okay, let's get rid of our probes. And what we can do, we can change the battery voltage. Let's make it 10. Okay, restart it. And now you see that we have 1.67 volts and 1.67 milliamps. Reasonable. Okay, let's turn that off. And let's get rid of our battery, and I'll show you another type of power. So let's go ahead and power sources, and here's VCC, VDD, VEE, and VSS, different power supplies. Make sure that you use these separately. Don't just change the name of them, because it will still memorize which one it was from before, and it'll be the wrong voltage. So let's just go ahead and use VCC. We have our ground. Let's go back and make them 12. Start it up, and we're back to our original voltage. So we could utilize this, our VCC or one of the other Vs, and use that for different voltages. Okay, let's build some AC circuits. So let's first thing let's do is grab our function generator, and let's just grab the standard two-channel oscilloscope. And of course, we're always going to need grounds. So we're going to need one on our common. We're going to need one on our minus, and our minus. Again, we're, see our red dot, we're connecting. All right, so let's just go ahead and use our first channel here. Open this up. So let's use a sine wave. Let's use 1 kilohertz. 50% duty cycle, 10 volts peak. So we're going to have a 20 volt peak to peak. Good. Let's go ahead and start her up. As always, the first thing we're going to need to do is change our time scale. And let's see here if we get a single. There we go. We got it triggered. And we have 5 volts per division. 5, 10, 15, 20. 20 volts peak to peak. 10 volts peak. And our frequency is 1K. So let's, and it looks like our period would be, let's take a look here, we've got 500 microseconds per division, so we got 1, 2, and it repeats, so we're 1,000 microseconds period. Okay, so let's turn it off, and let's say I don't like that color, so let's make it yellow. So we're going to change our segment color to yellow. Restart our scopes. Now we have a yellow trace. Okay, previously was the sine wave, so let's go ahead and try a triangular wave. There we have that, and we could also use a rectangular wave, or in this case maybe square wave because it's 50%. So this function generator will do those three functions. But we have several other ones we could use. If we go back to basic and we want to use, back to here, we want to use signal sources, and we could use AC, AM, bipolar, and we have a long list of these that we could put in place. So if we want to do DC signals, not DC, but for TTL signals, we can use a clock signal. And this will allow us to do 50% or whatever we need. And let's go ahead and fire that up. And let's close down our last one. And here we have a TTL signal, okay? And we can make it a CMOS, and we could use different amplitudes. So we have a 10 volt, and then let's go ahead and let's change the duty cycle. Let's make it 75. Alright, you see we have a 75% duty cycle. Looks like 75% high, 25% low, and looks reasonable. Okay, let me demonstrate one other interesting one we could use here. So let's get rid of all of this over here, and let's go over here and we're going to the bottom Tektronix oscilloscope. So we could also copy and paste these here. So let's ground it. And let's use one first channel here. Let's go to positive. If we go to minus, it's just going to be inverted. And let's open that up. And here we have the same Tektronix scope that we use in the lab. So let's go ahead and open it up. And we could change our time scale. And we could change our amplitude. And when you get all that, if you go to single sequence, it'll lock it in place and be nice. So we also have our measure functions and our cursor functions, the same as we do in our lab. So this is a nice way to simulate the ones that we use in the lab.